Scientists have long known that the key to interpreting the properties of a chemical is to understand its structure and bonding. Structure refers to the way the atoms are arranged in space, and bonding describes the forces that hold adjacent atoms together. So, today, we are going to look at one of the types of bonding, which is going to be the ionic bonds. Before we go into ionic bonds, we need to learn about why bonds actually form. The electrons in an atom are of two types, valence electrons and core electrons. Valence electrons are electrons in the outermost shell, while core electrons are located in the inner shells. Chemical reactions happen when atoms lose or gain valence electrons, while the core electrons are not involved in bonding or any chemical reaction. Now, atoms undergo bonding to do one thing, and that is to achieve a full outer shell. That is to have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. This is what drives all chemical reactions, and all these valence electrons move about to help atoms achieve this configuration, known as the OCTET rule. Atoms like the noble gases already have this configuration, thus tend to be very unreactive. On to formation of ions. Ions form when these valence electrons move about. Let's look at the formation of table salt, known as sodium chloride, for a better understanding. Now, sodium, which has an atomic number of 11, so it has one electron in its outermost shell. Now, to achieve an octet configuration, all it needs to do is to lose that electron, and its outermost shell will have 8 electrons. Moving on to chlorine, which has an atomic number of 17, so has 7 electrons in its outer shell, so it needs to gain 1 electron to have full outer shell configuration. Now, when these atoms come near to each other, the electron leaves the sodium and joins to the chlorine, and thus forms a positive sodium ion and a negative chlorine ion. Once these ions are formed, they are attracted to each other as they are oppositely charged, and thus forms an ionic bond. But remember, no physical bond is formed. It is merely an attraction of two oppositely charged species. Now that we know a little bit more about ionic bonds, we shall move on to covalent bonds in our next video. And as always, thanks for watching.